Remember what our Lord Jesus Christ said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have held too much to the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy laws. We have done undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare thou those who confess their faults. Restore thou those who are penitent. According to thy promises declared unto mankind, in Christ Jesus our Lord, and grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen.
The Almighty and merciful Lord grant you absolution and remission of your sins, true repentance, amendment of life, and the grace and consolation of His Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
who in the Paschal mystery has established the new covenant of reconciliation. Grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
your brother, who share with you in Jesus the tribulation and the kingdom, and a patient endurance, was on an island called Patmos, on account of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. I was in the spirit of the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a loud voice like a trumpet saying, write what you see in a book and send it to the seven churches, to Ephesus, to Smyrna, to Pergamum, and Thyatira, and to Sardis, and to Philadelphia, and to Laodicea. Then I turned to see the voice that was speaking to me. And on turning, I saw seven golden lampstands. And in the midst of the lampstands, one like a son of man, clothed with a long robe and with a golden girdle round his breast. His head and his hair were white as white wool, white as snow. His eyes were like a flame of fire. His feet were like burnished bronze, refined as in a furnace. And his voice was like the sound of many waters. In his right hand he held seven stars. From his mouth issued a sharp two-edged sword. And his face was like the sun, shining in full strength. When I saw him, I fell at his feet as though dead. But he laid his right hand upon me, saying, fear not, I am the first and the last and the living one. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys of death and Hades. Now write what you see, what is and what is to take place hereafter.
the evening of that day, the first day of the week, the doors being shut where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." Now Thomas, one of the 12, called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails, and place my finger as a mark of the nails, and place my hand in his side, I will not believe." 8 days later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. The doors were shut, but Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here, and see my hand, and put out your hand, and place it in my side. Do not be faithless, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen me and yet believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Before. On this evening of Easter,
disciples were in fear that they would be arrested and quite possibly murdered also by the Romans. Even though the disciples had been told earlier in the day that the tomb of Jesus was empty, they didn't seem to note that in their present situation. In our gospel today, we heard the word that in the midst of fear, in the midst of their doubts, in the midst of their uncertainty, Jesus showed up. Jesus showed up to give them encouragement. Jesus showed up to give them instruction. And Jesus showed up to give them empowerment. Jesus showed up, and the lives of the disciples were never the same again. Jesus appeared to the disciples in the locked room, and the first words he said to them was, "Peace be with you." And the disciples were at peace. All of the worries and anxieties that had bothered the disciples just a few hours before were now gone. The disciples began to see things in a completely different way. They began to understand things that they never knew before. They received the power to do things that weren't possible for them to do before. Now it's imperative and important to us to notice what Jesus didn't say. Jesus did not scold the disciples for getting his message half-backwards. Jesus did not berate the disciples for abandoning him to the cross. Jesus did not chastise the disciples for hiding out in fear, again, because they didn't get the message right. Jesus said, "Peace be with you," and there was peace. I think the disciples at that time may very well have remembered that the last time they saw Jesus, he promised them peace. At the Last Supper in John 14, Jesus informed them that the Holy Spirit would come to give them all understanding. "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. Not as the world gives do I give you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." The disciples remembered also the time they were in the middle of the storm on the Sea of Galilee, and Jesus declared, "Peace be still." And the rough and stormy waters became calm. And in the same way, the disciples, even though they were in hiding, knew that the storm was under control because Jesus was in charge of the situation. Peace brings order to our situation and calm to our anxiety. When Jesus promises peace, he speaks order into the places of chaos. So the disciples were encouraged to put their fear aside. The next word from Jesus was instruction. Jesus said, "As the Father has sent me, so I send you." Jesus gave the disciples a new job title and a new set of working instructions. The 3-year training period was over. They had been called to become the trainers of others, to share the good news of Jesus Christ to all the ends of the earth. And they needed peace because they could not complete that message, that mission, if they were in constant worry about their physical well-being. They could not be missionaries from behind locked doors. The time of hiding and running from the enemy has passed. The disciples have been called into their new full-time job. The promise that Jesus made to them at the Last Supper had come to pass. Thirdly, Jesus breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit." The Holy Spirit is the gift of empowerment. God never gives us instructions without giving us the empowerment to carry out those instructions. Jesus gave the disciples a new set of tools along with their new job assignments. The disciples were not empowered for ministry to do all the things that Jesus had done. They were now empowered to carry on the salvation of the gospel to all the ends of the earth. And that's what they did. You see in our gospel scripture that Jesus took a group of scared, undisciplined fugitives and turned them into Holy Spirit evangelists. They went from hiding from the enemy to making the enemy run away from them. Jesus declared encouragement, instruction, and empowerment. When the disciples received those gifts, their priorities were put into proper perspective. Their earthly perception was changed to a heavenly perception. The promise of our Lord to his disciples is also a promise from our Lord to us. It's a promise of peace. It's a promise of instruction. It's a promise of empowerment. Very often we look at our life situations in an earthly rather than a heavenly way. Sometimes we feel persecuted and abandoned. Certainly if we're going to walk this walk in a full Christian manner. Sometimes we feel like we're drowning in a sea of financial or personal or spiritual storms. We often cry out for peace, but sometimes we don't want to hear the instruction. Refusing instruction says to our God that we don't trust him, that we can fix our situation better than he can fix it, that we don't believe in the plan. God instructs us in Proverbs to trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Because leaning on our own understanding often causes our situations to appear hopeless, to appear unchangeable. Trusting in the Lord with all your heart means that we have to know what God's instructions are. We have to know the history and promises of God. We have to know the instruction manual, which is the Holy Scripture. The promise of God is that he will never leave us or forsake us. God has us in the palm of his hand, even in the midst of the storms that we ourselves have created. today, particularly with our people and our nation beset by wars and rumors of wars, our Savior Jesus Christ promises us peace. Our Savior gives us instruction so that we can become the examples of peace. And the Holy Spirit so that we can share that peace through our example. In the midst of fears, in the midst of doubts, in the midst of uncertainty, Jesus declares, "Peace be with you." Our God will bypass the locks on our doors and declare peace in our lives when it looks like chaos. God will replace the chaos with joy, like the disciples in our gospel today. He sends us out to share that joy with others. Jesus told the disciples, and he tells us, "As the Father has sent me, so I send you." The more we share the grace and love of Jesus Christ, the more peace filled our lives will be. Brothers and sisters, don't look at what the secular world looks like. Don't be stopped or shamed or stifled by what this world around us looks like, because we have a promise from God Almighty in the flesh. Jesus said, "Peace be with you." In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I believe in one God.
Buddy, Flavia, Beverly, Diane, Pat, Carol, Matthew, Christopher, and Katie. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ Church and the world. Almighty and ever-living God, who in thy holy word has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and in the unity and godliness. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially them and our bishop, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. We beseech thee also so to rule the hearts of those who bear the authority of government in this and every land, especially Joseph, our president, and Ron, our governor, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world. Open, O Lord, the eyes of all people to behold thy gracious hand in all thy works, that, rejoicing in thy whole creation, they may honor thee with their substance and be faithful stewards of thy bounty. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who, in this transitory life, are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to grant us grace so to follow the good example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, Saint Luke, our patron, and all thy saints, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then they were glad that they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the risen Christ be always with you.
And